Do you have any sense of alcohol?
No. I don't like, I don't drink soda with my alcohol. I don't really like carbonation with my alcohol. I just need one big rock, you know what I'm saying, for my libation. Hey, say what's happening, GQ? I'm T.I.P., and these are my essentials. Tea is an essential part of my day. Maybe 3-4 times a day I have a cup. Now, not that I run around with bags of tea, just loose tea bags in my pocket or in my book bag or nothing, but I will make a stop and make sure that I get me a cup of Earl Grey tea and agave for sweetener. I stopped drinking coffee about three, maybe four years ago. Tea was the likely alternative. Earl Grey was the first one that I tried because I asked which one has the best taste and the most caffeine. And they directed me to black tea. I begin to dabble between Earl Grey and English breakfast. Also chai, I do chai too, but Earl Grey is my favorite. These essential items are my J's. Fashion, fly, and comfort. That's very important, huge priorities for me. And my go-to is usually the Air Jordans or the Air Maxes, especially if I'm running in and out of town, on and off of planes, you dig? So these are essential for me. The first pair of Jordans that I ever owned, I believe, were the number fours, the Jordan fours. Mind you, I was probably in second grade, third grade at the time when they came out. And I just remember how, you know, how big of a deal it was when I got them. I have been a loyal enthusiast ever since. Aficionado, if you will. These are essential to me because it's like underwears and socks to me. This is an essential part of my undergarment fashion, I guess you could say. But the thing is, I don't like the fancy, you know, all of the expensive Neiman Marcus, Saks Fifth Avenue. I'm more partial to Hanes. They give me a tight fit. You know what I'm saying, that I need. The other ones are a little loose. And I don't think they understand the concept of an undershirt. Yeah, I wear under damn near everything. You know, I don't want my nipples just rubbing up against just bare shirts and stuff. You know what I'm saying? It just doesn't feel natural to me. Reading material to me is extremely important. I just, you know, like to keep abreast with, you know, the things that I guess are hiding from us inside of books. So I like to at least have one or two books with me for flights and just, you know, when I might be on long rides. I just try to, you know, just continue to keep reading in my daily. Bi-daily practices. You know what I'm saying? I try to read as much as I can. I don't read enough. So I actually started this book, Spook Set by the Door. I have not finished it yet. The Spook Who Set by the Door, man, and it's about a black man in espionage and how he has to kind of manage his ego and emotion, you know, to accomplish tasks and fulfill long-term goals. This is Behold the Pale Horse, written by William Cooper. This is a book about many, many secrets that the government has been hiding from the American people. William Cooper gave his life to share these secrets with us. At least I believe, you know, that's what I believe. I read it and I got halfway through it in 99 when I first got it. I got halfway through it and I thought, I was like, man, this could not be true. There's no way this is happening, right? Cut to everything. Now, today, everything this book talked about has come to pass. Everything. And so now, you know, I went back to it and started to read some more. Information is key. This is a crossbody messenger bag. One thing I hate, you know, is having like full pockets, like pockets everywhere. Phone and keys and bankroll and passport and all that, just all in my pockets. This bag helps me kind of keep things together without having a pocket full of clutter. Well, this specific one is made by Christian Dior, but I am not necessarily tied to the name brand of it all. This was a gift from my wife and I like it. And it's big enough to keep everything that I need, but not too big to carry around every day. So I usually give them about a 6-month rotation and then swap them out, maybe 3. When I'm on the go as much as I am, it's not like I know exactly where I may land. When I'm in the hotel, I don't necessarily know if they will have, you know, a stereo system or any kind of accessibility for me to play my music. I bring my my Bluetooth speaker with me. It sets the mood, creates my vibe, gets me ready to take on the tasks of all of my busy days. What am I listening to these days? Well, you know what? Oddly enough, I'm still listening to the Libra. I know it's a bit self-gratuitous, but it's exceptionally good. I also listen to Marvin Gaye, Hear My Dear. On the way here, I was listening to Al Green, Let's Stay Together, Curtis Mayfield. The 21 Savage album is dope. Thug's last album, definitely dope. I listen to Damani, Time Will Tell. Listen to Snow Allegra also. Janae Aiko, her last one was dope. Big Sean. Joyner Lucas, he just dropped one. I haven't heard it in its entirety yet, but looking forward to it. And always Tupac, Big, NWA, Snoop Dogg. Oh, I just reacclimated myself with the Doggy Style album. I hadn't heard it in quite a bit of time. And I'm talking about listening to it all the way down. It's just as dope today as it was in 93, I must say. This is a Red Rock ginger ale. While I don't drink soda often, ginger ale is kind of like one of the only sodas that I will drink. And Red Rock is my favorite ginger ale. I grew up drinking it. My grandmama started giving it to me as a kid when I got sick. And I didn't really like it then. It's real strong, strong ginger. You know, it burns a little bit. But when I got older, I began to enjoy the kick. So now it's kind of like my go-to ginger ale. And it's not sold a lot of places. When I see it, I grab it and keep them around.
Do you have any
alcohol? No. I don't drink soda with my alcohol. I don't really like carbonation with my alcohol. I just need one big rock, you know what I'm saying, for my libation. This is a Clive Christian fragrance. It is a 1872, I believe. You know, Clive Christian is a highly concentrated cologne here. When I say highly concentrated, I mean it has a thick oil presence. And how concentrated the oil is, it's gonna dictate and determine how long the fragrance will, you know, blend with your skin, how long it'll take to wash away. This is a an expensive bottle of cologne. They say it's because it's highly concentrated or the most concentrated, but I think you're just paying a lot of money for a fancy name. I definitely have different fragrances for different events, different environments, different vibes. I believe your fragrance is a part of your, it's a part of your personality. It's a part of like how you feel, what you're doing. The same way you get dressed, you wear a certain thing. If you're in a certain mood, I feel the same way about fragrance. This is a good daytime, you know, just a good daytime on my way out and about to start my day fragrance. I mean, it's also good for when you come home at the end of the day, then you take a shower, change clothes, and head back out, you know, to get your night started. You know, it's also good for that. It's kind of all around, all purpose, you know what I'm saying? It's essential. If not this particular fragrance, something as good or better. Right here we have an Aku hoodie. Now, Aku is my clothing line. We've been around for about working on our 13th year. And hoodies are essential for me just because as I travel, airport attire, or even just everyday running errands, you know what I'm saying? It's a way to stay comfortable, still be fashionable, and fly without being too extra. So an Aku hoodie is essential for me. So this is my portable charger. It's called My Charge. Now, the beauty of this is handling business. I run several companies and most of my business is handled on my phone. Most of the decisions that I have to make and the things that I have to review, either on conference calls, Zooms, emails. So it's very important that I maintain at least a half of a battery, you know what I'm saying? And this allows me to plug my phone up without having to sit still and wait on it to be charged from a wall plug. It allows me to charge my phone while I'm on the go and still handle my business. My goal is to at least keep it at half, and when I see it at half, to refill it or recharge it. When do I start to be concerned about the level of battery I have? Usually when it turns off, you know what I'm saying? Usually I don't notice that it's dead until it's dead. Probably in the middle of a discussion, in the middle of some sort of a task I have to complete, and bloop, phone cuts off. I want to thank y'all for hanging out with me, checking out my essentials. I guess if that's all, I'll see you next time. Love.